Hi everyone. In this video, we will learn how to formulate a linear programming model in a mathematical form. Linear programming is a very popular method in solving decision-making problems. Basically, linear programming is a problem-solving approach developed to help managers make decisions. This method is also called linear optimization and is used to achieve the best outcome given the constraints that are represented by linear relationship. This is a very popular method and has wide applications in all fields from business management, transportation, logistics, to aviation and airline management. This method can handle from simple to complex models. Of course, when we develop a complex model, it will take more time and effort to get it done. In this course, we will experience from simple models with only two decision variables to somewhat complex models with many more variables. In this video, I will show you an example of a simple linear programming model in business applications. First, let's look at three major components of a linear programming model. They are decision variables, objective function, and constraints. My suggestion is that before developing any linear programming model, you should write down these components in advance so we know what we need. Decision variables are related to the decision we need to make, and they are controllable inputs that we need to find out. They can be the number of products to be produced, number of stocks to buy, specific transportation schedule or location. The model will be developed using these variables. When we solve the model, we'll find the optimal values of these decision variables, which allow us to make the business decisions. The second component is optimization function, which is related to our expected outcome. The objective function could be maximization or minimization, depending on the business problem. For example, our objective could be to maximize the profit or minimize the total cost. The third component is constraints, which limit the degree to which the objective can be pursued. For example, we all want to maximize the profit, but have limited resources such as capital, labor, and equipment. In linear programming model, these requirements are represented by linear relationships. Before we formulate an actual linear programming model, we need to understand why we have to formulate the model in a standard mathematical form. Typically, the business problem is stated in a report form. Since this problem may come from the CEO of a company or head of a department, the problem statement can help us understand the problem and what are expected, but does not allow us to find the optimal solutions, which require the use of computer software. Most optimization software requires the model to be entered in a standard mathematical form, which is considered a universal language. Software like Lingo, SAS, or Excel only can understand that mathematical form and requires that form to find the optimal solutions. Of course, we can see several companies providing web-based decision-making tools, which allow users to answer some specific questions and then use the optimization algorithms to find the optimal solutions. But for this research purpose, we need to learn how to develop the model. Let's look at a simple linear programming model in the textbook, section 2.1, a simple maximization problem. This is a simple business decision problem with only two decision variables. PA Incorporated is a small manufacturer of golf equipment. Suppose they produce two new types of golf bags, standard bags and deluxe bags. Assuming the demand for these new golf bags is very high and the distributor has agreed to buy all the golf bags that the company can produce, the decision that the company has to make is how many bags of each type that they should produce to maximize the total profit given the constraints of their manufacturing system. The accounting department calculates that for each standard bag that is sold, The company will make a profit contribution of $10. And for each deluxe bag that is sold, the company will make a profit contribution of $9. This is based on revenue and cost analysis. Of course, the reality is more complicated than that, but we are looking at a simplified problem. So that is the information about the profit. Someone may say, the more we produce, the more profit we'll make. But our production capacity is limited by the resources. The production of golf bags requires four major operations. 1. Cutting and dyeing the material. 2. Sewing. 3. Finishing. And 4. Inspection and packaging. The manufacturing department did some analysis and specified the number of hours needed for each operation for these two types of bags. These are aggregate values based on both machine hours and labor hours. Table 2.1 shows this information. For example, each standard bag requires 7 10-hour cutting and dyeing, half hour of sewing, 1 hour of finishing, and 1/10 hour of inspection and packaging. We can see the information for the deluxe bag as well. In terms of capacity, the director of manufacturing estimates that 630 hours for cutting and dyeing, 600 hours for sewing, 708 hours for finishing, and 135 hours for inspection and packaging are available for the production of golf bags in the next 3 months. That means we cannot use more than these numbers of hours, which are the maximum capacity. Let's formulate a linear programming model for this problem. Note that formulating models is a combination of art and science and can only be mastered with practice and experience. There are no concrete steps that we can just follow and get it done, and there is only general guidance. Nonetheless, some problems may share similarities, and throughout the course, we can see one approach that can be used to formulate the same type of business problems. The first step is to determine the decision variables for the model. As indicated before, the objective is to determine the number of bags of each type to be produced in the next 3 months to maximize the profit. So we'll have two decision variables, the number of standard bags and the number of deluxe bags to be produced. I will call S the number of standard golf bags to be produced. You can call anything you want, but I suggest making the variable names short and simple, since we'll need to include it in the model later. A lengthy name can make the model very clunky and hard to follow. I will call D the number of deluxe golf bags to be produced. We need to make the definition of the variables very clear, because when we find the solution later, we need to interpret the results, and this definition will be very useful to us. In this case, S and D refer to a very specific number, which is the number of bags to be produced. In some other examples, we'll see that decision variables could be the number of hours, the amount of dollars, the number of stocks, a specific transportation route, or beginning time. So please do not define a variable simply by a name of the product. For example, I would avoid defining S as standard bags, since it is not meaningful to decision-making process and hard to interpret. The next step is to formulate the objective function. Verbally, we can say that our objective is to maximize the total profit. But how can we put that in a standard mathematical form in terms of the decision variables? This is important to find the values of these decision variables. Now, the case states that for every standard bag that is sold, the company makes $10. So I add max to denote the maximizations. $10 is the profit contribution of one standard golf bag. So if we have S standard golf bags, the total profit from standard bags would be 10 times S. Note that this is not an actual number, but an expression of the total profit received from selling standard bags. Similarly, for every deluxe bag, the company makes $9. So the total profit of deluxe bags would be 9 times D. This is a mathematical expression of the objective function. Let's move to constraints. In this simple problem, we can see that the company has limited capacity related to 4 operations. Each operation has a maximum number of hours that can be used. The first constraint is related to cutting and dyeing operation. The case states that there are only 630 hours available for this operation in the next 3 months. That means the company can use at most 630 hours for this operation. So we put the statement here. Cutting and dyeing process cannot use more than 630 hours. How can we put this in the mathematical expressions? We'll look at table 2.1 again and focus on one operation at a time because the constraint is for the operation. One standard bag requires 7/10 hour of cutting and dyeing. So we put an expression for the standard bags here. One standard bag requires 7/10 hour. So S standard bags require 7/10 times S hours. Since this operation is used for deluxe bags as well, we need to look at that information. One deluxe bag requires 1 hour of cutting and dyeing. So we put an expression for the deluxe bags here. One deluxe bag requires 1 hour. So D deluxe bags require 1 times D hours. Thus, these expressions, 7/10 times S plus 1 times D, shows the total number of hours required in the cutting and dyeing operation. And this should not exceed 630 hours. So we put less than or equal to 630. That is how to formulate this constraint. For other 3 operations, we'll follow the same process. The second constraint states that sewing process cannot use more than 600 hours. We'll use the same information in table 2.1 to formulate this constraint. So we will have 1/2 times S plus 5/6 times D less than or equal to 600. The third constraint states that finishing process cannot use more than 708 hours. So we will have 1 times S plus 2/3 times D less than or equal to 708. Finally, the fourth constraint states that inspection and packaging process cannot use more than 135 hours. So we will have 1/10 times S plus 1/4 times D less than or equal to 135. We have converted all verbal statements into mathematical expressions. Let's put the mathematical expressions together in a standard form. I will change the color of these mathematical expressions to red. Then we copy them down here. Linear programming model. This is the objective function max 10s plus 9d. Instead of saying constraints, we write subject to. This is a standard form and is used by most optimization software. Then we copy all constraints down here. First constraint, second constraint, third constraint, and fourth constraint. Actually, we have one more constraint. S and D should be non-negative. Note that S and D refer to the numbers of golf bags, so they cannot be negative. In some cases, the software might find multiple optimal solutions, and this constraint will tell the software to ignore any negative solutions. So that is the linear programming model in a standard mathematical form that can be used by any optimization software. Note that some textbooks or journal articles present linear programming models in general math forms using Greek letters. I like this textbook because it presents the models in simpler math forms, which are understandable to people who are not familiar with general math forms. But remember that most journals require the paper to present linear programming models in general math forms. In addition, when you have a very complex model with a large number of variables and constraints, The general math form can present that complex model in a more effective way. In this course, we will stick with the standard form as we see in the book. But I will show you how to rewrite this model using a general math form. This will give you some general guidance on how to do it, should you want to publish your paper in a journal. This model can be expanded to more products and operations without changing the model. Here is the same linear programming model in a general math form. Let's look at the variable definition. We'll call xi the number product I to be produced. I is the number of products, so it can be any number from 1 to n. Xi must be non-negative. Xi is our decision variable. But we have some more parameters in the model. Pi is a profit contribution of product I. So you can see the objective function here is max sigma of Pi times Xi. This expression multiplies Xi by Pi and then sum these values, which represents the total profit of all products. For constraints, we see some more parameters. Hij is the number of hours required for product I in the process J. So J represents an operation or process. J can be any value from 1 to M. Capital Hj is the number of available hours for the process J. So the constraint can be written as sigma of Hij times Xi less than or equal to capital Hj. Now I write here J equal 1 to M. That means we have M constraints even though we write only one constraint expression. If we have I equals 2, that means 2 products, and J equals 4, that means 4 operations, then we have our model for this business case. This is the same model with the one we have before, but we present it in a general math form using Greek letters and can apply for a bigger problem. As you can see, presenting the model in this form is a very effective way, especially when we deal with a complex model with a high number of variables and constraints. However, the challenge is to understand the math signs and how to use Greek letters. So again, in this course, we will not use this form and will stay with the standard form as presented in the book. That is how to formulate a linear programming model. Thank you, and bye now.